चाटना।
गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स एंड वेलकम इन बृहन मुंबई म्युनिसिपल कॉर्पोरेशन वर्चुअल क्लास। वी नो दैट वी आर सफरिंग फ्रॉम अ पेंडेमिक सिचुएशन एंड इन दिस पीरियड वी आर गेटिंग ऑनलाइन एजुकेशन थ्रू बृहन मुंबई म्युनिसिपल कॉर्पोरेशन। आई होप यू ऑल आर फाइन एंड टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस ऑन अ डिफरेंट टॉपिक which will be very interesting and knowledgeable for you. First of all, I'm here, Mr. Sandeep Andare from RS Nagar Municipal English School, Mahim. Students, today we are going to make a different thing from a subject, play, do and learn. And today we have selected an interesting topic. The name of that is making pinwheel. You know that pinwheel means it looks like a windmill. Everyone, have you seen windmill? Yes, students, have you seen windmill? I hope you all had seen that windmill. If you don't have seen, I'm going to show you that it looks like that. Okay, students. So let's discuss on the topic, that is how to make a pinwheel. Okay, for that, we know that if you want to make anything, you have a need of particular material. And that's why today also we have need of particular material. And we know that every period, every lecture, we learn different things. And today, whatever we are making means a pinwheel. About this pinwheel, we are going to learn step by step that how to make pinwheel. It's very easy and simple. Just you have to take care of something, like you have to handle some sharpened things very carefully, like pin, then scissors. So students, important material for making pinwheel is, first you have a need of paper or cardstock. Very good. Second object, that is scissors. Third one, glue stick.
Glue sticks.
Yeah. Fourth one, crayons or markers. Anyone. You can use marker. It is easy, okay. Or it will be available. You can make it available very easily.
Then, okay.
Fifth one, pencils with scissors. Pencils with scissors means?
Pencil and scissors.
Not a pencil and scissors. You have need of pencil. You know, at the end of the, means on the top of the pencil, there is a eraser, you know, which is fitted in one metallic plate, which is roundable to that, right? And it is at the end or at the top of the pencil, right? That pencil you have needed. Okay. Then push pin. And this one you have to handle it very carefully because it is sharpened. And similarly, scissor also. These two things you have to handle very carefully. Other things are not injuries to you. It will not make injuries, but these two things can make you injury. That's why you have to handle it very carefully. Then seventh one, bead or small buttons. It is optional. You can use any one from these two beads. If you have beads at your home, you can use beads. If you don't have beads, you can use small buttons, which you use on your shirt, right? Different t-shirts. Now we are seeing that they are using colorful buttons on the shirts and t-shirts. That button also you can use for that. It is depend upon you that what thing is available with you. So this is optional. So these seven things are very important for making pinwheel. So students, let's learn step by step that how to make pinwheel. First step of making pinwheel is you have to take two A4 size paper, right? Any color paper you can use, whatever is your favorite color. Okay. Otherwise, you can use different designable papers, whatever. Those paper you like, but it should be A4 size, right? Then second step is make a pair of squares. Now you have to make a pair of squares. So what you have to do in this step, start out by cutting two identical squares from paper or cardstock. Whatever paper you have selected, you have to cut identical squares. Means from the both papers, you have to cut square shape. Okay. Which is shown in the picture. First one, this one, and second one, this one. You have to make this type of circles on the paper and cut it very carefully. Then, if you are keen on using templates, you can choose two from any of our pinwheel templates and print them out on letter or A4 size paper or cardstock. Now, in this step, what you have did, till you have did that, you have took two papers, drawn a square shape on that. Now what you have to do, if you can draw a big squares on that, you can draw a big square. Otherwise, by drawing small squares, you can take out print out of that on color paper. Means it will the shape of that squares will be perfect. Then the next step is you have to decorate the squares. Okay. Whatever design you can draw on that, like your favorite designs, or you can draw pictures, whatever is your favorite, or flower pictures, whatever. You can leave the squares plain or draw some patterns on designs on the dam. Okay. In this step, what you have to do, if you want to draw designs, you can draw designs. Otherwise, you can leave plain. So this is depend upon you that what you are doing. If your favorite design you want to draw, you can draw. Otherwise, you can leave it plain. The next step, cut out the squares. Now, if you have left the plane, you can cut out the squares. Otherwise, if you have drawn the designs or other favorite things on that, now cut out the both papers squares. In this type, you have to cut it very carefully. At the time of cutting, you have to take care of one thing, that your finger should not get injured because of the scissor. Because a scissor is very sharpened thing and it may create injuries to you. So carefully and in the observation of your parents, you have to cut it. Otherwise, you can take help of your parents or your elder sister or brother. You know that it can be create injuries to you. That's why you have to cut it very carefully. Then the next step is glue the squares together. Now, whatever paper you have cut, you have to glue the means you have to stick it both papers together. How we have to? You have to put one another one, and at the middle, at the center, you have to stick with glue. Okay, not a complete, just at the center by putting one dot. By putting one dot, you can. By putting one dot, you can stick that. Then glue the undecorated side of the squares together. Those sides are not decorated. That side you have to stick, right? Then remember to apply glue not just along the edges but on the entire back area of the squares. Let the glue dry. Now carefully, in this step you have to spread glue on the whole page, and you have to press it very carefully, and also you have to leave it for drying for a few minutes. Okay, then the next step is, now you have to cut four sides similarly on on single pages you have cut already. Similarly on both papers you have to also cut that four corners very carefully. And if you can't understood, if you are not understanding, you can see it on the picture, in the picture, that how you have to cut it. These four corners you have to cut it very carefully. But how you have to cut it? You have to cut it half. Look, if you are not using templates, cut four dialogue lines starting from the corners, going up halfway to the centers of the square. Means full paper, you don't have to cut, no need to cut your full paper, just you have to cut halfway, because at the center you have to leave it without cutting. Then the next step, that is, bring one tip to the center. In this step, you very carefully, first of all, you have to give the numbers to each corner. Okay, means both sides. For example, first corner you have choose, on the one side you have to give one number, and on other side you have to give two numbers. Means both side will be number, there will be numbers. Carefully you have to tip to the center. Now after making the four slides, okay, after making the four slides, you will have eight tips. Whenever you will cut four corners, you will get eight tips on your square. These are labeled with numbers on the photo. Similarly, you have to give the numbers on that. And why you have to give the numbers? For keeping in mind or for understanding the procedure or the step, you have to give the numbers. Whenever you will give the numbers, you will understood very easily and quickly. That's why you have to give the numbers. Otherwise, there is no need to give the number. But for first, for making 2 to 3 pinwheels, you have to give the numbers. Then take one of the tips and bring it to the center. First tip you have to take and bring it to the center of the square without creasing the paper. One thing you have to keep in mind, that you don't have to means whenever you will bring that tip towards the center, on the other hand you have to hold remaining paper very carefully. It should not fold. Other paper, remaining paper should not fold. Then you can glue the tip in the place or just hold it with your hands. If you want to if you want to stick that corner on that center with glue, you can glue stick. Otherwise you have to hold it for a minute, for a few minutes, because whenever you will bring all the tips toward the center at one time, you have to use the pinwheel, and by using the pinwheel you can feed that. So you can glue the tip in place or just hold it with your hands as you do the next step. Same steps you have to do next time. that look. Number three. First number you have chosen and you have means bring the first tip you have brought towards the center. Now you have to leave number second and directly you have to choose the third. Means by leaving one, you have to choose third one. Similarly, by leaving fourth one, you have to select fifth one and bring it toward the center. Leave the sixth and bring the seventh. Okay, so this will be the procedure. You can glue it, place, or just hold it with your hand. Similarly, you have to hold it with your hand. Otherwise, you can use glue for sticking. Then bring the remaining tips to the center. Similarly, you have to bring the other tips to the center. Next, bring tip 5 and then tip 7 to the center. Either glue them in place or hold them with your hand. Okay. You can stick with glue, otherwise you can hold with your hand. And now, if you have not sticked glue, now those paper you have holded with your hands, now you have to do one thing, that you have to take a pin, and it is sharpened, you know, so you have to hold it very carefully and use you have to use it very carefully. Insert a push pin at the center. If you did not glue the ends of the tips in the previous steps, the push pin should hold all four tips together. Wiggle the push pin around to make the hole a bit larger. Means you have to make a larger hole on that paper. So why we are making a bigger or larger hole? Because it should move automatically whenever we will hold it towards the air. It should move automatically. That's why you have to make larger hole with that pins to that paper. So in this way, now carefully you have to use that sharp push pin. After then, attach the pinwheel to the pencil. Now you have to attach the pinwheel to the pencil. So that's why I told you that you have to use carefully and you have to handle it carefully. Those pencil I was explaining to you, those pencil I was told telling to you, that was this. Okay, I hope that you are understood that which pencil with eraser. So this pencil was that which you are looking in the picture. This pencil you have to select. Okay, so now what you have to do in this step, attach the pinwheel to the pencil. You have to attach the pinwheel to the pencil, to a pencil, by pushing the pin into the pencil's eraser. In this step, you have to insert the push pin in the eraser very carefully, and easily it will go, it will enter, or you can insert it very easily because there is an eraser. So don't push on too tight to allow the pinwheel to spin more freely. But whenever you will insert the pinwheel in the eraser, one thing you have to keep in mind, that if means tightly you have to insert that pinwheel in the eraser, it should not move automatically. It should be fitted in that eraser. So as an option, you can put a bead or small button between the pinwheel and the eraser. So next material we are using, that is button or bead. Before entering the pinwheel in the eraser, you have to enter that button, whatever you are using. If you have bid, you can use bid, or if you have button, you can use button. Whatever you are using, before entering the pin wheel in the eraser, first of all, you have to entered the pin wheel in the button or bid, and then you have to enter the pin wheel with button or with bid in the pencil. In this way, carefully you have to insert that pin wheel in the eraser, and this help. Why we are doing this? Why we are inserting this pin button or bead in the pencil in that pin wheel? Because of that, this help the pin wheel rotate better and prevents the pins point from going through the other side of the eraser. This is the main intention behind this, for using the bits or small button. So carefully and very by means, particularly you have to insert that pin in the eraser. So this is the proper method of making the pin wheel. So similarly, you have to follow all the steps. Now you can see that your pin wheel is ready. Now you can enjoy with pin wheel. You can enjoy your pin wheel. Finally, try blowing at edges of the pin wheel to make it spin. After following all the steps or procedures, you have to blow the corners or edges of the pinwheel. Because of this, it will swing very properly. So loosen the pin a bit if the blades do not rotate well. So now, by following all the steps, you can make the pinwheel. Now you can enjoy your time with this pin wheel. You can hang it on the walls or in the ground or on the terrace, right? Whenever wind will flow, it will run automatically. So these all are the explanation. Now I'm going to show you in video that how you have to make the pin wheel in short. Okay, so everyone see carefully that how you have to make the pinwheel, and you will understood each and every steps with this video. I hope that you will enjoy and see carefully this video. Now I'm going to start the video, but before that I would like to tell you that there are so many methods of making the pinwheels. You can also make simple pinwheel and also make a different type of pinwheel, like flower pinwheel. Means the edges of the pinwheel will looks like a flower. Look at this pinwheel. Okay, you can make this type of pinwheel. Just what you have to do, you have to cut the edges or the corners of the square papers like a flower petals. If you will cut that very carefully, you can make this type of pinwheel. So students, you can make simple pinwheel or a designable or a flower type or other type of pinwheel also. But whenever you will make it, you have to take all the precautions when at the time of making the pinwheel. Okay, make a longer stem. You can also make a longer stem to that pinwheel. If you want to longer handle, use a wooden dowel in place of a pencil, pushing the pin into the wood in quite hard for kids. So make sure an adult does this step. You can decorate that dowel by painting it or wrapping its entire length with fabric ribbon. Look at these streams, this one, like this one. So this type of streams you can use, or longer streams you can use to hold it in your hands. It is depend upon you what you have to do. If you want a smaller stream, you can use smaller stream. Otherwise, you can make a longer stream too. And on that wooden sticks, you can use for that. So on that sticks, you can wrap a colorful ribbon or a paper. Because of this, it will look pretty like this. So these all were the explanation. Now I'm going to show you in video that how you have to make the pinwheel. So everyone, look at the video very carefully and follow the steps. Are you ready of enjoying the video? Yes, students. Are you ready? Can I play the video now? Students, can I play the video? Can I play the video now? Yes, students.
Yes, sir.
Okay. This type of pinwheel you have to make. So if you want to make this type of pinwheel, it will swing like this. Okay. If you want to make this type of pinwheel, you have to follow the steps which I'm going to show you in this video. So carefully you have to follow. Okay. It will swing very fastly. So these are the steps. You have to take one square paper. You have to fold like this and press with your thumbs very carefully. It should not tear when you will pressing it. Then this corner you have to turn to that corner. In the middle you have to fold it and then press it with your thumb. Okay, now next step that you have to fold from half of the corner, and also you have to press at the center, just at the center, not a full. Similarly, remaining petals also you have to, or remaining corners you have to fold halfly and just press at the center of that corner. Till the press point, just you have to cut it with scissors. You can use glue sticking that, otherwise those procedure I have told, that pin, you can use also that one. But if you will use glue, it will be helpful or easy for you, because push pin can injure you, and with the glue you can stick very easily. So I would like to suggest that maximum students are all So I hope I will suggest that everyone should use that glue for sticking the corners at the center, mean the tips. Proper word for that the tips. Now all tips are sticked properly at the center. Now the next step, that pencil with eraser or stick also you can use. It's not compulsory to use that pencil with eraser. Okay, now enter the pinwheel in that very carefully. Okay, in this step your finger may be injured, so carefully you have to insert. Look here, without eraser pencil is used, but I would suggest that you have to use pencil with eraser. Why? Because it will be easy for you to insert the pin in there. So these all were the steps whatever I have shown in the video. I hope that you all are enjoyed the lecture, and definitely we will make it very easily. So it's time to homework now. Definitely homework will not other than this, just you have to make a pinwheel. But how many? 2 pinwheel you have to make by using the different color papers, whatever is your favorite. So I hope that everyone will make the pinwheel. Okay, so students, best of luck for your pinwheel, and thank you for watching.